and said, ma'am, I don't think we're going to be able to let you through because your picture on your ID looks fake. It looks like a cartoon character. This is true. This happened. And I'm thinking in my head, you know, even if it did look like a cartoon character, I don't think you're supposed to tell someone
careful.
That. Yeah. If he would have said that to the wrong person,
careful.
Y'all, that would have been that would have been bad news. Very, very bad news for him.
Yeah. Hey there, and welcome to 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins. My name is Luke, and I'm the producer of this podcast. Really glad you joined us for this episode. Listening to the podcast is a wonderful way to get to know the Erwin family, but if you want to meet them in person, you might be able to see them live on tour. Now, if you want to see a full list of all of the places they're going to be performing and touring, simply head over to their website, erwinministries.com. And while you're there, make sure to check out their latest single, Still Telling My Story. Now, let's get you over to your co-hosts, Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie. They are the 4Ks in a Pod.
Bring on the fire. Bring on the rain. My testimony is not gonna change. From the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story.
Welcome back
The
4Ks in a Pod podcast. Here are your hosts, Keith Erwin, Kody Erwin, Christopher Erwin, and Katie Erwin. We are all here.
Hedrick.
Katie Erwin, Hedrick. Hey, we should do the intro like we used to do interviews when we were little and new to Southern Gospel.
Hi, I'm Keith.
I'm Kody.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Katie.
And we're the Erwins.
That's how it was.
How homeschooled was that?
Luke needs to use that in every episode, maybe.
Please don't.
Please.
It would even be better. It would even be better if he would find audio of us doing that way back in the day when we really did sound like kids.
It's on YouTube.
And he could use that as the entrance.
We're not
intro.
Doing that, Luke. We will fire you.
We're not doing
you're
that.
You're fired.
Definitely not doing that.
Duh.
I don't know. I like that.
Your
like
job hangs in the balance, Luke.
No. Hey, it shows the history behind the voices that these people are hearing. We've done it for quite a long time, and this is just another outlet that's opening up our ministry to you guys, and that's what we want.
Hey, with that being said, y'all. Thank y'all. This is episode 4.
Episode 4.
That's crazy.
Wow,
and it's all because of your support to this podcast.
Right.
And you are the listeners. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's the wrong one.
That's the wrong one.
You wanted to clap, huh?
That one.
That's it.
You're laughing at us.
Yeah. We weren't laughing at you guys. Cody's still
well, kind of.
Still learning. Cody's still learning the board over here.
Hey.
That's funny.
And I love that right before we hit record, I literally leaned over to Kody. I said, hey, let's work on those sound effects a little more. Let's try a little bit more sound effects this episode. Well, so you know what, Kody? You're trying. You're trying.
Well,
it does say they're labeled. I just wasn't reading. I was guessing.
At least it wasn't like a do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
No, that one's this one.
Oh,
that one.
Oh,
love this.
Oh.
This one.
Oh, yeah.
That's my favorite sound effect.
We'll use those in October.
That's a little spooky.
Around Halloween.
A little spooky.
Yeah, it's cool.
Hey, but for real, thank y'all so much for trusting us and letting us take up some of your day today with listening to our episode 4 of 4Ks in a Pod.
That's right. And our mission statement is to build stronger friendships and to network these friends to other friends through various stories, fun topics, and enlightening interviews, all while glorifying Christ.
Amen.
There you go.
Amen. Hey, and I actually found one of my favorite Bible verses that I want to share for our verse this week. It is Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7, and it is, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ." It's actually through Christ Jesus.
Through Christ Jesus.
I said that wrong.
Philippians.
Philippians 4, 6, and 7.
Or as 2-year-old Landry says, Philippians.
Philippians.
That's what he says. Because we're teaching him a Bible verse.
You know what? You really can't go wrong with Philippians.
No, you can't.
Hey, no. You can't go wrong with song. You can't go wrong with song. You can't go wrong with song.
Can't go wrong with
writing a song.
We need to write that song.
Who said that? You?
I did an episode 2.
Wow.
For the real ones that know what we're talking about. If you haven't listened to episode 2, go back and listen.
Go back.
It's pretty funny. So, but we need to have Landry to do the Bible verse sometime on here.
Yes, yes, yes. He's got a couple that we're trying to get him to do on stage, and we really haven't had a whole lot of opportunities yet because he just hasn't been with us on the road. But it's fixing to happen a little bit more with him in the summertime, and Lindsay's going to be on the road a little bit with us. So, yeah, he's got a couple of Bible verses that we may have him do it on the stage. That would be cool.
He's so cute. I'm obsessed with him.
He's crazy.
He's wild.
He's crazy.
He's wild.
Love him.
So guys, one of the other ways we were wanting to connect with you guys is through this email address. And we've given it in the last, really every episode, just for you guys to interact with us, because that's what we want. That's really the main goal of this podcast, is to talk with you guys and for you guys to get to know us. So again, the email address is the word four, the letter K, and the word pod, 4kpod@yahoo.com. And we do have some people that have emailed us that I don't believe if there's a whole lot of questions, but just some statements that I'm going to go ahead and read off.
Give us a couple.
Okay, so here's Carrie Moore that actually posted a photo. I'm going to swing my laptop around for you guys to see all this.
Cool.
Remember those sweet little girls?
I remember them. Aww,
they were so awesome. That little man.
Louisiana, right? Is it Louisiana?
Yeah, I believe, man. I think it's Louisiana.
Was that the night with
Maybe
Joseph?
Maybe East Texas. I can't remember. I remember the picture.
You know what? They came and saw us. This picture, if I'm not mistaken, is the one over there in, where we did the Bible conference with Lee, Tim Lee. They came and saw us, and that
oh,
was...
Yeah.
Kemp.
Kemp, by Athens.
First
yeah.
Baptist
oh, yeah.
Church,
oh, yeah.
Kemp. They
yeah.
came and saw us,
right.
And that was a long drive for these sweet people. I remember that. And
look at those shirts.
Yeah, so they have all of their Erwin shirts on, and just
so
the
sweet.
Kindest family in the world. And she says, "Good evening, Erwins. We are so excited for the podcast. My littles are enjoying this. We cannot wait to see you again."
Aww. Cool.
So, that is so sweet.
Very cool. Miss Carrie, thank you so much for doing this and for sending us this picture. It's awesome. I'm going to save this picture.
Hey, send it to me. I might post it on social media, too.
I will do that. I will do that. Yeah, that would be a great idea. So Miss Carrie, thank you for giving us some input here on this email address.
What else we got?
Brian Olson says, "Congratulations on the podcast. Hey guys, congratulations.
Aww.
I will be listening to every episode the day it releases. Y'all are truly gifted, and I look forward to seeing you in concert again soon. You meet so many people. I'm not sure you remember, but my wife and I came to your concert in Glen Heights, Texas on a Sunday morning. Yeah. Our bus dropped us off very early, so we got to watch you set up your equipment. For a guy who has a degree in sound engineering and music, I was enjoying that more than you probably thought I was. Anyway, congratulations again on the podcast and continued success and God's calling on your ministry."
That is so
sweet.
You
know what? I remember him sitting in the corner laughing at you while you were setting up the sound.
Probably.
I'm kidding. Now that he's up, no. What a great, great sweet couple we got to meet. I remember them.
I clearly remember them.
That's
sweet,
so sweet.
Sweet couple.
They loved our song,
Give It to God.
Give It to God.
Yeah,
and
we sang it.
Yeah, we didn't sing it during the set that
After.
We had, but they mentioned that they came to see us, and they loved that song. So I remember we gathered around them there, and we sang a little acapella chorus for him.
That's
I remember that.
Very sweet.
We sang Give It to God for them. So Brian, thank you.
Yeah, come
thank
see us again
soon.
Thank you
for listening to the podcast.
Again.
Thank you. Kelsey Pyatt says, "Hi, I'm Kelsey, and I'm 20. I love listening to your music." Well, thank you, Miss Kelsey, who is 20.
Hey, we got some new music coming
soon. That is exactly right. We have got
By the time you're 21.
Yes, as it's going, I don't know how old you'll be when this comes out, but
it'll be worth it.
It will be. We can't wait for you guys to. So, Miss Kim Miller, of course, who is a family friend, close family friend, the Millers, we love them so much. She says, "I just listened to your first podcast, and just know that y'all are a blessing, not only through your music, but also through your podcast. I have watched all of you grow up since you were born, and our family has always loved your family. We're thankful for all that you do. My most important memory of y'all is the love you showed to our family when we lost Dylan. We did not have to call y'all to come sing at his funeral, but your dad called us and y'all came. We didn't even pick out the songs, but God put on your hearts the best song suitable for the time. What a day that'll be. What a blessing and honor to have friends like y'all in a time that we were hurting the most and y'all poured into our family. We will forever be grateful. What a life celebration for my son. It was absolutely amazing. I love y'all and pray God continues to bless you all. Kim Miller, Broadus, Texas."
Well, I'm going to cry.
Yeah.
That is so sweet.
She's just an amazing mother and an amazing person, and her whole family, Brother Micah.
They're great.
And just everybody there, very close to us. And that was one of the honors of our ministry, to be honest with you, singing at Dylan Miller's funeral. Young man who we never thought would leave us that early, but God's ways are not ours, and we just trust our plan. And in the meantime, we never forget the impact that Dylan Miller had on the Erwins.
And also, for those of you who have a physical copy of our CD, Favorites on Repeat,
that's right.
Inside of the CD, we dedicated that album to Dylan Miller, and it talks a lot about he and his family and how much we loved him in that CD. So be sure, if you don't have a copy, to get a copy of that, and you can know a lot more about Dylan. We love the Millers. We love you guys so much.
And me and Keith played basketball yesterday for about 3 hours at a rec center on the road. And there's not many times that you pick up a ball and don't think about, I don't think about Dylan. And, because that was always a big thing. We'd always talk about ball and talk about...
Tremendous athlete.
Wasn't he taller than you guys?
He was. He was one of the few.
Yes, a little bit.
Yes, he was, man, I don't know.
I think he was 6'8 or 6'9. I mean, he had to be 6'8 or 6'9, maybe. 6'8
or 6'9. So, but just a great young man that I can't wait to see. We're going to see him very soon.
Yep.
But we love all the Millers. Thank you, Miss Kim, for your email. Marlene Booth says, "Hey guys, I'm normally not a big fan of podcasts. I like seeing who's talking to me, LOL, but I'm a fan of the Erwins, so I'm listening, and y'all did a great job. When you talked about this will be a good way to get to know y'all better, all I could think was, or go on a cruise with them.
Keep up the good work.
That is a good one.
I'll be listening, Marlene Booth. And so we love Marlene. She has been on a few cruises with us and a frequent passenger on the cruises. And we always have a great time.
Yeah.
Always have a great time.
You know, if Marlene is wanting us to give a plug, we can do it.
Yeah.
It's true.
Go to our website or be watching, because there's going to be some news coming out.
Yes, go to erwinministries.com for more information about a cruise that we are taking in September of 2024.
Yep,
we're going to Canada and to New England, and it is out of Boston, Massachusetts, which is really cool.
Massachusetts.
There we go.
I
was curious if she was going to tackle that word.
It's a tough word.
Massachusetts.
Oh, my. I just
Massachusetts. Careful. You got to be careful there.
Massachusetts.
Yeah.
There we go.
Need an interpreter.
But thank guys. We are humbled by all the kind words on the emails, and we may reach to a few more. But you guys keep sending them, please keep sending the emails, and because we'd love to hear from you, and it's a great outlet to learn more from y'all as you learn more about us.
That's right. And I don't even think we've addressed where we are talking from today. We are in hot, sunny California.
That's right.
We are on the West Coast.
Sacramento. Yep, we're here. The West Coast Caravan Tour.
We're
pretty exciting, man. It's been a great few days. Flew into Portland from Detroit. Which is just seamless. I mean, it sounds easy when you say it quickly.
5-hour flight.
But it was good. I mean, great dates in Detroit area. Yeah. And then we flew out west. And
in the flight, it was early. I at least slept the first half, but then I was awoken from the pilot announcing on the plane.
It was loud.
It was loud.
It was a loud moment.
Like everyone, you saw him jump at once. But he said, it was for a good reason. He said, everyone, look out who was sitting on the left, look out to your left, open your windows, and you'll see Yellowstone National Forest.
Park.
Okay.
The forest. Forest. You know.
That's my number one place I want to visit.
The forest.
The forest.
Yellowstone National Forest.
It was great from the airplane.
There was a great. You saw it all. Mountain that we passed.
Yeah. Someone said the name. I don't remember.
There were actually multiple coming into Portland. There was one that was close, like parallel with the plane. Like we were lower than the mountaintop.
Hold up.
And then there was one further out. Toward like further into Oregon.
That
was
Mount Hood.
Yeah.
It's Mount Hood.
Mount Hood.
It's in Oregon.
There it is.
I had a lady tell me that when we sang in Oregon, I was telling her the same thing. We flew over a beautiful mountain that was taller than the plane. Granted, we were starting to descend. And I know I've said on here, they're laughing at me for how I said that. But I've said on here that flying is my biggest fear. And I did not like seeing elevation taller than what we were. You know what I mean? In the sky.
Yeah. I mean, granted, we were coming in for a landing. I mean,
we were
less than 10 miles from the airport. But
it was
still
spooky, y'all. Mount Hood, it's beautiful.
Oregon was great. You know,
we checked it off the list. That was our first. Well, as the Erwins, as the a group.
Erwins, you know, 15 years ago.
Right.
No, wow. 25 years ago, probably, when I was a young child, I'm probably the only one that would remember. We were in the Dells, Oregon.
Exactly.
And we were there for 2 weeks. Dad held a 2-week revival at a church there. And all I remember as a young child is it rained every single day we were there. It rained every single day. So I guess they have a rainy season up there. And so
that was 15 years ago, and they had not had us back since.
Right, no, they haven't. But man, I was a young child. I don't know if y'all were. I don't know who was here and who wasn't.
I don't remember it. I was second born. So
yeah,
I mean, that was actually.
I think I was there. I was just a baby.
Yep. I stayed at home.
Stories.
Well, back then, mom, who is just
you weren't born.
We don't.
Yeah. What year did you say it was?
25 years ago.
It was 25 years.
Oh yeah,
ago.
No,
not
I
15.
Yeah, no, I wasn't at home.
You weren't here.
No.
Not yet.
But I don't even remember what I was going to say. Oh, we really need to give proper props to mom.
Proper props.
For having a 3-year-old, a 2-year-old, and a newborn.
All traveling.
Could you imagine?
Guys, that explains a lot.
And I'm looking
when
at
you're
Kody,
listening to
I'm
us.
I'm looking at Kody because we're the ones with children. Could you imagine a 3-year-old, a 2-year-old, and a newborn on the road
traveling.
In a van, not even a bus, and hardly flying? I'm sure we flew to the Oregon, but to have that, and it was weekly back then. Like, we were gone. We were, like I said in the first episode, we were doing 45 Sunday through Wednesday revival meetings a year. So you're talking about always on the road, always living out of a suitcase.
Yeah, I don't know why she did that. I do not know.
Well, it was
either.
The Lord. The reason.
It had to have been.
It had to have been.
There's no other person that could have made that.
And honestly, it explains a lot more why she stays at home now.
Oh, my goodness.
she
has grandkids now.
That's true, yeah.
But yeah, just a big, major, major appreciation to that lady for what she did.
Yeah, for
and
sure.
And she continues to do, because she's awesome.
She's the best.
The West Coast trip I was talking about, we flew to Portland, sang, and we got, so we flew, so we don't have our bus.
Or a rental car.
So there's groups here on the caravan with us, Legacy 5, Taranda Green.
Greater Vision, Booth Brothers.
Yeah, and so some of them have buses, so we just jumped on. Some of us got on Landon and Taranda's bus, and then some of us got, me and Keith and Tucker got on Legacy 5's bus. And it was cool, you know, it was different, you know, being on other people's buses definitely is just different.
Yeah.
You know, it's cool. I'm sure it's different for them too, not having normal people on. So,
yeah.
That's true.
But it was cool, you know. I mean, we had a bunk, which was a great thing.
Some of us did.
Yep.
The ones on the L5 bus did.
Yep. Yeah.
But honestly, I'll just go ahead and say this. Landon and Taranda have been leasing Mark Lowry's bus since Mark is not touring this weekend, I guess, or the next few weekends.
Yeah.
So we actually were on Mark's bus, which is gorgeous. It is so beautiful.
Yeah, it's immaculate.
It is 100 times
it's nicer than
the level of our bus. Like, it's insane.
It makes our bus look like a
we appreciate our
public,
bus.
A public
yeah, 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 no, we
oh,
do.
No, of course. No,
but
we didn't write Mary Did You Know.
I was about to say, this is Mary Did You Know money.
That's absolutely. Yeah.
And we love Mark, and we love his bus now that we know what it is and what it looks like. But we actually got to sleep in beautiful recliners.
Yeah.
Honestly, they were the comfiest recliners that I've ever slept in. And I've never flown first class in a plane. I know this is a little different. I've never flown first class, but the closest thing that I could imagine what it would be like would be those recliners that we slept in. Like, it made down to a pretty nice bed.
Well, that's good.
It was nice.
You know?
I'm glad that it was like that for y'all.
It was great. Sure.
I didn't get into Mark's bus very much. I just kind of looked at the front part of it, and it looked amazing.
I'll tell you what these buses have. That ours doesn't.
Say this.
Say it. A front.
Say it.
Slide.
It makes a difference.
And it's a slide out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, but like our bus doesn't have it. I will say it is tighter. The rumors are true. It is tighter when you close them.
It is.
Unless our Legacy 5's was, it seemed like. Smaller, it's just by inches we're talking about.
Yeah,
but
it's worth it.
Oh, it is so worth it. It's nice. It's like you're in somebody's living room in their house.
My favorite thing, it never fails. Every single person who says, "Oh, don't get a bus with a slide out. Don't get a bus with a slide out."
They get a bus with a
they
slide out.
They have a bus with a slide out.
Well, it's just another, in their defense, it's another thing that breaks. I mean,
grass is always greener. Well, but the grass is always greener.
And that's with everything on a bus. Everything can break and will break.
Like a house.
At some point.
I was going to say, yeah. Anything that can break will break.
It's going to be worth it.
It's even worse.
It's worth it to have one, though, for sure.
It makes a difference, especially when you're on it 200 plus days a year.
Well, yeah.
And think about it. Most of the time when it's closed, obviously, it's always closed when you're driving, and everyone's usually sleeping or like in the back in their bunks.
No, it's a must.
Yeah.
For sure.
So then when you're parked, it's like a whole legit living room.
For sure.
In there up front. It's
beautiful. Nice. It's cool.
Beautiful.
Good for them.
Yep.
Love it.
Let's write Mary Did You Know part two.
Let's try.
Do we have any road stories? Have any road stories?
Hey.
Let's try to maybe put one road story per episode or something like that. We've got more than enough to dish out, I'm sure. Katie, do you have one?
I had an interesting experience this past weekend at the airport.
Okay.
I don't know if y'all want me to share
that with
everyone.
Yeah, sure you can. It is interesting.
This was a first for me, and we had a very early flight from Detroit to Portland. I mean, I say very early. It was like 9 a.m.
That's gospel singer early.
That's early, y'all. So we get to the airport at like 7:30. It's packed. It's a madhouse. So they're sending us to like this underground security type thing to get us checked in quicker because our flight was about to leave. We were running late. Erwin standard time. It's a thing. So I get to the security. It's finally my turn. Walk up to the podium. He asks for my ID, which I handed to him. I gave him my boarding pass and he looks at it for a couple seconds and he goes, "Is this you?" And I was like, "It's definitely 100% me." And he kept looking at it, turned it around, grabbed a flashlight out of his pocket, studied my ID, and said, "Ma'am, I don't think we're going to be able to let you through because your picture on your ID looks fake. It looks like a cartoon character." This is true. This happened. And I'm thinking in my head, you know, even if it did look like a cartoon character, I don't think you're supposed to tell someone
careful.
That. Yeah. If he would have said that to the wrong person, that would have been bad news. Very, very bad news for him. Yeah. But
bad news bears.
Bad news bears. But thankfully, after about 10 minutes of studying my ID, he got another security officer over there to look at it, and he was the one that sent me through, thankfully. But also another side story to all of that is I always travel with a backup plan. So I always have my ID and my passport whenever we fly. And so whenever this started, I told him, I said, "I have my passport so I can prove that it's me." And he said, "I would love to see that." So I go to my backpack and I'm starting to look through it.
That's what I saw. I heard something happening because there's two counters. I heard something happening, and of course it was Katie, and I was like, "Oh, you know, maybe, you know, whatever."
I'm panicking.
It's just something simple. And all I see is Katie just throwing stuff out of her backpack.
Just
and I'm
fervently,
like, well, this can't be good.
Yeah.
Of course, I saw you give him the ID.
Goodness.
So I was like, well, surely it's just a formality or something.
Yeah, so my passport wasn't in my backpack.
That is fun.
I left it at the hotel in Detroit. Thankfully, now we have it back. The pastor of the church that we sang at got it for us. So all is well now. But at the airport that morning, it was bad news bears for me. But they ended up letting me through, so it's not bad news. And I safely got to Portland.
Peasants, general boarding, Kris. Me and Kris have the TSA pre. And Katie and Kris, Katie could have TSA pre. They just simply haven't gotten it yet.
And the other day, man, the TSA was crowded.
It was long. That's right.
Like, I think we got there before y'all.
Yeah. Well, because they moved us to the underground security thing,
Detroit.
Like I said.
I was wondering where y'all went.
Detroit. Yep.
Dude, they sent us to the international area.
Yeah, they did.
Like all the way, it was like three levels down. It was crazy.
Yeah, Detroit Airport TSA pre kind of defeats itself.
Well, and I'm sure the time, Monday morning I would think.
Yeah, it was just a bad time
business
to
people,
fly. Yeah.
Business people would know more than me, but I would think Monday morning would be the busiest time to fly.
Probably.
So anytime that happens is probably the reason.
Hey, but we did upgrade this time. We didn't fly Frontier.
We didn't.
We fly Delta.
About Frontier.
That's a lesson you learn once.
You know that.
That's a lesson.
That the higher ups.
You get what you pay for.
Yeah, you know that the higher ups of Frontier are listening to this podcast. You know they are.
That's right.
I hope so.
Make up for it.
And
I hope they're taking notes.
We're forgiving people.
We love Delta.
Speaking of the West Coast, the last time we were out here on the West Coast was a couple of years ago. And we were at the home church. Yeah, 2021. We're at the home church, an incredible church, one of my favorite places to visit. Yeah.
Lodi, California.
Yes, Lodi,
we'll be
California.
There again in October.
We'll be there in October. I'm sure we'll say more about them then. But We went to San Francisco like we have done many yeah. times.
It's a beautiful place.
And with Luke.
It's a nice place to visit.
His family. Yeah, yeah. So it's a great place to visit. And we always go with Luke and his family. So they took us out there and we're at the piers, you know, at the area
eating
of the piers.
Some oysters.
Eating some oysters and eating some affogato.
Blue bottle coffee.
Oh my goodness. If you guys are ever in San Francisco or New York City, because there's one in 30 Rock.
Yeah. I think they're all up and down the West Coast for sure, like L.A., I
know there's not a whole lot of locations.
Okay.
But Blue Bottle is fantastic. I think they're out of
San Fran.
Seattle.
They're French. What's French?
France.
What's French?
Where is French?
Hey Siri, what's French?
Hey Google,
what's French?
Hey Google.
French me.
My mind was so caught up on the story, I forgot.
French fries.
Simple English. Anyway, so I think
Where they make them French fries and French toast.
Yeah. Mm. So they're out of France. Anyway, Blue Bottle.
Yes.
Didn't mean to say that. I regret that we did. Mm. Anyway, Blue Bottle's great. So we have a rental car, of course, a big SUV rental car, and we park it in this pier area, and there's four or five cars that's parked there.
Public parking.
And so we go and walk around the piers and all that and see everything, and we come back, and before, at least my personal remembrance of the story, before I even look at the car, I see glass on
everywhere.
The ground. Everywhere. In fact, there's parking spaces that are empty with glass everywhere.
Right.
So clearly... the cars got hit and they were vandalized
left.
And either, I mean, I don't know. We didn't really think. I don't know if the people took the car or if hopefully they were, the owner saw that happen and left. We never know. But anyway, so yeah, we were broken into and we had the product bags that we have now, the product suitcases. Yeah. And right now we have, five?
Yeah.
That trip, we probably had three or four. It was only a few days of a trip. And so they were gone. Nothing in the back of the SUV. And so we're like, well, what do we do now? This was Saturday. We were serving at the home church on Sunday. We had no product to sell at this point. And so we were like, well, so we call the cops. And, of course, in San Francisco, they really don't do a whole lot.
Investigation.
Yeah, they don't do a whole lot.
They're like, all right. You can give a report, but it's not like they – sometimes I don't even send an officer out.
We talked more to the rental car company than we did.
Let's say that the legal system in San Francisco is not exactly like it is in East Texas. So anyway, that's kind of the deal. So we called them, and they didn't have it. I mean, they couldn't do anything. So we just kept walking. We're like, well, it's already done. Yeah. Nobody's in there. I mean,
what are we going to do?
Nothing's in the car, so we might as well continue.
We went and got more oysters.
Yeah, that's right. So what, a couple hours later, guys? Is that right? A couple hours later, we get a call from
an
off-duty
LAPD officer. Yeah, and we are we're just walking around the city, and we get a call because for those of you who have maybe our physical copy of our CDs, you'll know that we have an office number there on the – on the back of our CDs. And also on the suitcase, though, that were stolen, it's so funny, right before we left, we never do this because we just fly so frequently. But this one trip,
Dad was with us,
of course. And so he
made sure we tagged it.
And he was tagging all the bags, you know, put our personal cell phone number on it. And so we get a call from an off-duty LAPD officer who's visiting his daughter up there in the Bay Area, and he's running along Coit Tower, a trail there at Coit Tower, and he says, hi, am I in contact with any of an Erwin's or like any type of Erwin? And you're like, yeah, this is Keith Erwin. He said, well, we're sitting here walking along Coit Tower, and there are four suitcases just laying about the sidewalk with a bunch of CDs in it. And so only in San Francisco can you get robbed and then your suitcases returned within a few hours.
Hey, those thieves, they didn't want Christian music.
They didn't want gospel music.
They didn't want Erwin music.
And I clearly remember telling Dad as he was making those little pieces up, the addresses and the names on each suitcase, Dad, we really don't have to do that. We don't have a layover. There's not a whole lot. And, you know, our bags are not in jeopardy of being lost. And then sure enough, this is the trip where they get stolen, and the guy finds our name and number, and by God's grace, we get all of our product back that was all in those suitcases, and I think they took our credit card machines. I think that was the only
the
thing
square
that they...
Square machines.
Square machines. I believe that's all that the thieves saw some value in.
Hey, it was worth it for that Blue Bottle coffee.
That was, man.
It all ended up working out.
San Francisco, like Christopher said, is a good place to visit for a few hours or maybe a day or two, and a very cool place.
Yeah.
Very cool place.
It was. I want to go back.
The West Coast is cool.
Oh, we love it.
Of course, we're in the summer and it's hot.
Yes. Oh, it's.
I mean,
there's
like,
heat advisory.
You think of California, you think like, you know, sunny and 75 or coastal air. Dude, it is warm
now,
out here.
Portland was beautiful.
Now, there's no humidity, cool. Which is nice.
Right.
But it's hot.
It's hot. Portland,
heat is heat.
When we flew into Portland, it was.
It was 58 when we landed that morning.
It felt like a Christmas December. It felt like a Texas December.
Christmas December.
That's every year. It feels like that every year.
In Massachusetts.
Yes.
Massachusetts.
Was that better?
Say it again.
I'm not.
Yeah.
People can rewind it if they want to hear it again.
I'm not.
I can't believe you said it the first time. Yeah. So.
It was very bold of me.
It was good.
Thanks.
Here's another road story. Do y'all remember what happened in Sefner, Florida, January of 2023, just a few months ago?
Oof.
So we had a very crazy Saturday night, Sunday morning turnaround, even a Sunday turnaround.
This was one of the first big trips of the year, right?
It was.
Yeah.
Katie wasn't there.
I had COVID.
That's right. That's right. But to start the year, we were beginning our year. Katie wasn't on the bus. We had some bus issues going out there, if y'all remember. We made it 100 miles. And our bus breaks down. We're in Longview, Texas, on the side of the road at 1 o'clock in the morning on a Friday night. No, was it a Friday night? Yes, Friday night, 1 o'clock in the morning. And that's just like we were just stuck. We're like, well, this is going great. A good start to 2023. And we're there until what, 11 o'clock that morning, the next morning?
I mean, yeah, we waited for people and we had to wait for parts.
Yes.
They knew the issue pretty quick and it was easy to get to. Trying to remember what it was. I don't know. It was,
but the part, we didn't have the
part. Yeah, we didn't have the part.
With a huge drive still in front of us.
Yes, going to Florida.
Well,
yes.
We were in like Longview. We were like an hour and a half away or something like that.
Away from the house.
From home, yeah.
Yeah. So long story short, we don't get into Jacksonville, Florida until 2 o'clock in the morning, of Sunday morning.
Right.
Late Saturday night. And we've got a Sunday school concert that Sunday morning, the first Sunday morning of our ministry year as far as what we do. So we were just running around trying to get everything, situated and everything. Dad, so that Sunday, Dad hits the side of the church. Y'all remember that?
He backs into the gutter.
Backs into the gutter.
Their gutter up.
Yep, kind of bends their gutter up. I'm sorry, Blanding Boulevard Baptist Church, once again, for that happening.
We haven't been back since.
Yeah, we're scheduled
we are
back
there.
Oh, we are. You're right.
It's not even been a year, Kris.
You're right.
But anyway, yes. So that happened. Happened on Sunday morning. Sunday night went fairly smooth, but we get to Sefner, Florida at Sefner First Free Will Baptist, where we are every year. It's a tremendous place, tremendous Bible conference. Monday morning, we wake up and we can't get in the bus. Dad parked the bus up next to a curb. Anybody that's ever owned a bus knows that when you park it for a few hours. Goes like the airbags. Isn't that right, Kody?
I don't know if every bus, but at least our bus.
Isn't the airbags? Isn't that what it is?
It's an air system.
They
buses
deflate.
Are. And then they have front, back, and then rear, right, left, and then rear air. It lifts.
Yeah.
And if the bus is turned off, there's no air being generated, no air buildup.
Yep. So it just goes down.
And we have a right side leak is the issue.
Yeah.
So well, door side.
But that night, whenever he parked the bus, it wasn't the case because, of course, the bus was on.
Engine. Right.
Yeah, the bus was on and the air was up.
The bus was engine.
Yeah, yes.
The bus was engine.
Katie lost some drink out of her mouth there. So when we wake up the next morning.
The bus is engine.
When we wake up the next morning, the bus door is literally is sealed shut.
Yeah.
With the curb. It's a concrete curb. We can't open the bus at all. We can't even get in.
We're stuck.
We have a morning service, if y'all remember. That morning.
Yeah. We are a mile away from the church, and it starts in 10 minutes, though.
To be fair, it was 45 minutes before it started because we were fixing to leave to be there 30 minutes early. So we had 45 minutes from the time Dad called me. I was fixing to finish getting ready in the hotel. And just to back up a little bit more, I was fixing to be finished in the hotel to get on the bus to go to the church. And Dad calls, hey, we can't get in the bus.
Yeah, we had set up the night before.
Correct, yeah.
And
late. Which, that's nice. At least y'all
did
that.
Yeah, if we wouldn't have done that, it would have been train wreck.
That's right.
And the curb was, there was probably 2 inches of space. I mean, no one could get in there. And I was like, well, what are we going to do? You know, we tried to start it from the back in some buses, or at least air the air compressor hooked into the back air lines, and that'll raise the bus up. But I don't think the compressor was strong enough. Something we couldn't, or power or something, we couldn't, it wasn't working.
Amber Epinette tried to help us. I was about to
say, yeah. And then in the 11th hour, the 11th hour came through.
There it is.
Well, honestly, they did help us, not the way they thought they were going to.
Right.
But they had their RV there, and they had some tools and everything. I think we were trying to even chisel the concrete of the curb. Did we try to do that?
I may or may not have.
Yeah, so we were just trying to get that, because literally church was fixing to start. All of our, and
plead
not
the
to
fifth
mention,
on that one.
Not even to mention all of our suits and the dress, Katie's dresses were in the bus. Yeah, so we just had, you know, jeans and t-shirts on. We weren't going to be able to get on stage there. And so long story short, I'm thinking maybe we can just put the RV close to the bus.
And have Kody.
Yes.
That's what you were thinking.
I volunteered Kody as tribute because Cody's not afraid of heights like I am. If I'm standing in the chair that I'm sitting in, I'm just frightened. So I'm just horribly afraid of heights. Kody gets on top of Amber's RV, hops on top of our bus. We do have an emergency hatch.
Yes.
Every bus, I think it's actually law to have an emergency hatch on the bus.
Yeah, every RV.
Amber is in the house. Tear off your roof of fear.
Wow.
Tear off your roof of doubt. Wow. For those 11th hour fans.
That is okay. So, man, there's just puns everywhere.
Sorry.
Anyway, so Kody lifts the emergency hatch up, climbs from the top of the bus into the bus.
Drops down.
Cranks the engine, lets the airbags. And so, I think it was starting at 10 that morning.
You know what?
A sunroof.
The bus's engine. At that point,
the bus is engine.
So
I have no idea where
we're giving Kody. There it is. Kody the applause sign, running some applause.
You know what I've learned from listening to y'all share this story? Because I've not heard all of those details because I wasn't there. I have learned two things. Y'all need to keep me around, number one, and the bus is engine, number two.
I don't know if that would have prevented
fixing that issue.
But maybe it wouldn't have happened.
Anyway, we walk in.
I don't know.
We walk into the church at probably 10:15 because we were throwing our suits on. And we walk in at 10:15. They'd already started. We literally, if y'all remember, missed stride from the time we walked off the bus to we walked on stage.
And he said, the Erwin.
Yeah. We literally walked off the bus at the church, and we walked on stage and sang our first song. You guys, I'm telling you, if you are not going to learn anything about this us during this podcast time, you're going to learn that the road life
is tragic.
It's crazy.
It's glamorous.
You literally never know what's going on, what's going to happen. And really, one of the main reasons why I love it so much is that you just never know, and you got to just go with the punches. And
Not why I love it.
I don't like that part.
That's not why I love it at all.
I enjoy it, man.
Woo!
It's all we've known. It's all we've ever done.
That's true.
Yeah,
and
for sure.
It's what we do. It's what we're going
to
do.
It's what we're going to continue to do. It's what we want to do.
We're going
to
say that story, too, at some point.
Absolutely
probably
not.
Probably our first interview ever.
Man.
But anyway, yeah, we've got a whole lot more road stories that we're going to share with you all, because that's what we want to do. We want you guys to get to know us. These stories that we're telling are not normally told. Mm-hmm. And so that's what this outlet does, is for you all to hear them.
And we still want to hear from you.
Absolutely.
You have our email.
Absolutely.
In the description, our email will be there.
And yep.
Hey, and we are going to start interviews very soon with some special guests.
Yeah, hey, and with that email, let us know some people you want to hear from. We already have a ton of ideas, but if there's anybody in adjacent to our ministry or, you know, synonymous with what we do that you all want to hear from, let us know.
Hey,
Dennis and Tiffany are on the list.
We've kind of already hinted that they are going to be our first guest whenever that comes time. So if y'all specifically have a question or something to say to mom and dad, please send us an email with that being said, and we will ask or say that in that episode.
Or any generic questions you want to hear answered from any of us, collectively or individuals. We're pretty open books, and we'll be happy to share and enlighten for information.
Or 4kpod@yahoo.com, FourKPod@yahoo.com.
Yep.
And you can just send us anything and everything, and we would love to. I guess I should say this, and I didn't say this to any of the people that I've already read emails off of on the episode. If you don't want your email read on national television, if you don't want your email read for everybody to hear, you may want to give me kind of that deal. But
put it in the subject.
Yeah, put it in the subject. and I hope and pray that it was okay for everybody that I already read and I didn't ask. But anyway, it really means a lot. All the kind words. that you guys tell that you guys are giving to us. We just praise the Lord. Everything that you are hearing and seeing that's good from us is all because of our Lord, and we give Him praise for giving us this opportunity in ministry to not only do what we do on a nightly basis, but also to do this and to talk with you guys as we have time and get to know you guys more as you get to know us more.
And keep listening. Share this podcast with all of your friends and family. And be sure to keep watching for our next episode.
Yeah. Hey, before we go, we got to do what we're doing every episode or what we try to do. We got to talk about share a song. Share a song.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah. I'm going to start with, because our tour mate for this West Coast part has been Taranda Green.
Woo.
One of the absolute...
Oh, it's crazy.
Most incredible vocalist.
I asked her if she was real the other night.
Yeah, she.
I did.
Those of you who never heard her, just...
It's pretty amazing.
I've been a fan, honestly, my entire... As long as I can remember, I've been a fan of her voice and her talent. But just hearing her live and in person and being around her more... The older I've gotten, it's been an absolute treat to see how incredible, like truly, it's mind-blowing. You all need to look her up. But anyway,
so
her song, He's Been Faithful.
Oh.
That's what a song.
Written by Miss Carol Cymbala.
Absolutely.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I did not know that.
It's an incredible lyric and song.
Wow.
And Taranda just, she never misses. It's amazing.
It is so good.
Great song. That's my choice.
So mine is Brian Free and Assurance. The album, Nothing But Love, is such a great album. And specifically song is, let's see, where does it go? Yeah, I Want to Be That Man. So cool song.
It is a good song.
Melody. And
who wrote it?
I don't know. Let me look. I
have
it pulled up right here.
Didn't his son write it?
I think, yeah, Ricky may have.
Didn't Ricky write it for Brian? I feel like they talked about that.
That's cool.
Before.
It doesn't. It's not pulling up. Maybe it's not.
Sometimes Spotify says. Sometimes it doesn't.
What song did you say, Kody?
I want to be that. Man.
I want to be that man. No, I think Ricky wrote it.
Yeah, Ricky did. Yeah, I know that for a fact.
He writes a lot.
That's what I thought.
Yep. Fantastic.
I am going to say a beautiful song that actually, y'all, one of my best friends in this world wrote. She was a bridesmaid in my wedding. I was a bridesmaid in her wedding. My beautiful, talented friend, Miss Heather Rose Jordan, used to be Samson, now Jordan, with the Jordan Family Band, and I want to give a shout out to her song called Jesus and Me. It's beautiful. I love it.
The Erwins here on this pod, 4K's in a pod, we're fans of JFB.
We love JFB.
We are fans of Jordan Family Band. They are great.
They're great.
They are.
Great people.
Great music.
Great ministry. Mm-hmm. Very talented.
Mm-hmm. We love y'all.
Instrumentalist people. I mean,
they can do everything.
World.
They're great.
And writers. Josh writes almost all of it. And Heather now. Crazy.
I got one that's another Caravan Tour artist in Legacy 5, What Kind of Man.
Oh, yeah.
What a song. What a song. And did y'all know who wrote it?
Sue.
Jason Cox, Kenna West, and Sue Smith.
So good.
Yep. You can't beat that trifecta of writers. Great people.
It's so good.
Great song. A lot of Erwin songs.
My goodness. Great song. If y'all have never heard Legacy 5's What Kind of Man.
Lee tears it up.
Oh, my goodness. It's just a great group of guys. Legacy 5's a great bunch of guys. We were on their bus just a couple nights ago. So.
Sure.
I highly doubt that Lee Black is listening to this, but I told Kris the other night when you were singing, Lee, that I want to get a t-shirt made.
Oh, yeah.
And it's going to, because you went for the super high note the other night, and we were backstage listening.
Yeah.
And I want a shirt that says Gah, so G-A-H, and then have a picture of only your face. So it's golly.
Yeah.
Get it?
Oh, Katie.
I'm going to do it, Lee. I'm going to do it.
I'm going to do it, Lee.
I'm going to do it. Because you are one of my favorite tenor singers in this industry. So
absolutely.
We are so proud
Scott
of you.
Scott Fowler's going to want to sell that shirt.
Golly.
Scott Fowler.
I'm kind of disappointed in Scott that he hasn't.
Oh, he will.
Give me my royalty, Scott. I'm kidding. We love Legacy 5 and Lee Black.
And we love each and every one of you guys.
Yes.
And we will do this again. We'll catch you next time
on
the 4Ks and a Pod
podcast.
We
love y'all. Jesus loves
you. Thank you, Luke Clayton, for your work also.
Thanks for joining us for this episode. And please take a moment to follow us on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, or wherever you listen to podcasts. It would be really helpful and appreciated if you could leave us a 5-star review and share this podcast with your friends. Also, if you want to reach out to the Erwins with any questions, comments, or feedback about the podcast, simply send an email to 4kpod@yahoo.com. That's FourKPod@yahoo.com. You can also see the show notes for that email address, and we're really excited to hear from you, and you never know. If you send an email with a question, it may just be featured on a future episode. This podcast is hosted by Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie Erwin, and it's produced by myself, Luke Clayton, and my team at mustincrease.com. Thank you once again for joining us for this episode, and we look forward to seeing you next time right here on 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins.
Bring on the fire, bring on the rain. My testimony is not gonna change. From the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Still telling my story.